professional drum shop founded in 1959 by Bob Yeager, began doing in-store clinics, starting with Louis Bellson in 1961. In November of 1977, Bob put on one of the largest and most expensive clinics for its time, free to the public. It was called the Rock Jazz Fiesta, with John Guerin in his band, Jeff Porcaro in his band, and Louis Bellson in his orchestra. This event was recorded on reel-to-reel for Bob's personal use, and were missing for over 35 years and recently found. This is the first of the three performances by John, Jeff, and Louie.
Fiesta. Your host for this afternoon, the president of the professional drum shop, Bob Yeager. Welcome. That's beautiful. I'm glad you found us. You know, they changed the name of the theater. I put the advertising out. This place was called the Longhorn. And I got it all out and they changed it back to Aquarius. So, we better get the show going before they change it again. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you this afternoon to the world's most expensive drum clinic and concert that's ever been performed to my knowledge. One thing, how do you like my tuxedo? First of all, I'd like to introduce some celebrities in the audience. Many years ago, well, not that many really, we had a little girl drummer used to come in the shop. And I turned her on one day, and she's one of America's greatest singing stars, Miss Karen Carpenter. Take a bow, Karen. Right on in there. Put a spot on her. And now, like to thank the people who helped us put this on. From the Ludwig Drum Company, we have their West Coast representative here, Mr. Jack Gunther. Jack's right out of here. From the Pearl Drum Company, we have Mr. Walter Johnston and Mr. Jeff Kessler. Stand up, fellas. And then from Remo Incorporated, Mr. Remo Belly, whom I affectionately call Mr. Plastic Head. Remo, where are you? From Pollard Industries, we have Mr. Joe Pollard. We'll be out on stage in about 2 minutes, and then you can give him a big hand then. From the Zildjian Company, Abbott Zildjian, the makers of the world's greatest cymbals, we have Mr. Lenny DeMuzio and Mr. Rab Zildjian. Thank you very much. Now I'd like to pay special tribute. You know, usually when we have a clinic like this, I introduce people individually. But suddenly, as the years have gone by, it's really progressed into one hell of a ball game. And I'd like to pay tribute to all the professional percussionists and the professional teachers who inspire and educate our young people into making better drummers in a better world. Would you all stand up, please? Every professional drummer, percussionist, and teacher in the audience, please stand up so everyone can see you. Now I'd like to tell you about the prizes you received some tickets as you came in. Number one, we're going to give away an electronic syndrome valued at $2,000. Number two, we're going to give away a Pearl drum set, which is valued at approximately $1,100. Number three, we're going to give away a Lubbock drum set, which is also valued around $1,100. And from the Lubbock company, we're going to give away a Lubbock super sensitive engraved Black Beauty snare drum with case at value of approximately $500. It's sitting right over there. And also from the Zildjian company, we're going to give away a 20-inch, an 18-inch, and a pair of 14-inch hi-hats to three different people. And also a pair of pearl conga drums valued at $400 roughly, one to an individual and the other one to someone else, you know. And a pair of Remo Rototoms with a stand at the value of $214.50, and a leather cymbal bag with a value of $90. And I think that, we have two drum thrones that Mr. Guerin and Mr. Porcaro will be sitting on from the drum workshop. They're called the DW Thrones. Two of those will go, and they're valued at $125 apiece. To meet a man who has invented the electronic syndrome, Mr. Joe Pollard. Thank you. Thank you, Bob. For those of you that aren't familiar with the syndrome, it's an electronic drum. We basically developed it so a drummer could expand a little bit rather than have 9,564 drums around his set to create different sounds. We've tried to make this unit so it's applicable in live performance, and hopefully it will hold up well on the road too. We've tried to look at all angles that we could. I think today you'll see a lot of different uses with the drum and a lot of different styles of playing, which should give you some ideas. If you have any further questions on it, I suggest you contact Bob down at the drum shop, and he'll be able to answer most of your questions. Thank you very much. What happened? And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to get the thing rolling. I'd like to introduce to you a young man who I've watched grow the last 10 or 12 years. He has become one of the greatest drummers on the scene today, and I'm sure that he's going to go down in history as one of the all-time great drummers. Mr. John Guerin and his group.
Saturday afternoon after 2. The long holiday, it's hard to keep track of things. But I have kept track of who's in my band this afternoon. And they're all longtime friends, except for the pianist, and he plays so well. I'm going to start out with him. He's new to this city. He's from San Francisco. On the Fender Rhodes, Russ Ferrante. He's currently playing in the fellow next to him's group, guitar. We've had a long association with the LA Express. His name is Robin Ford. On guitar. Monaco and I go back as far as 1963 in many different areas of the music business. He moved out here from Chicago and very close to that year. And I'm very proud to have Chuck DeMonaco on the Fender Grand Prix. We've got a couple of original tunes for you this afternoon. This happens to be Robin Ford's, called 7 Come 11. After that, we'll play a Russ Ferrante original called The Imperial Strut, and then we'll see you after that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Beautiful. Beautiful.